Hi, I'm Maddie Anthus. I'm in the Center for Student Success, and I'm going to do a quick tutorial so students can see how to enter a Google Meet conference. Advising sessions might be held on Google Meet, and classes might be taught this way, so I want to make sure students know how to access those conferences. I'm going to show you a couple different ways to get into it, but you want to check with your professor as to how they expect you to access the conference themselves. I'm going to present my screen, so it might look a little funny for 1 second. Bear with me. So if your advisor or professor has invited you to the conference through Google Calendar, the easiest way to access it is to go to meet.google.com, and that will bring you to a screen that looks like this. So here you can see that you are signed in at the top. And then if you have been added to conference sessions through Google Calendar, they will be listed here. So you can see I have a 10 a.m. and then an 11:30 a.m. To join into one, you just click onto it and it will bring you to what looks like kind of a lobby before you enter the conference. That's how I refer to it. Here you might get a pop-up about enabling your microphone and your camera, so you want to make sure that you do that. However, I also recommend there are these options at the bottom below your face. You can turn off your microphone and turn off your camera. I definitely at least recommend turning off your microphone. That can help if there's a lot of people, if you're in a class with multiple people. There's always one person who doesn't remember their microphone is on, and you might hear conversations or eating, things like that. So it's good practice to turn it on. Sorry, turn it off. You can also turn off your camera. But the other option I want to show you is if you do not think that you have strong internet or you're not sure you'll be able to understand what's going on in the conference through your computer, you can have the option of doing a phone call to join. So if you click this, it will tell you a couple ways you can join. You can enter your phone number and the Google Conference will call you, or you can dial in. It gives you a phone number and a PIN, and that way you can enter directly. However, if you click join now, that's another way of directly entering it. I'm not going to do it right now just because if I enter in a conference with myself, there will be a feedback loop that sounds pretty terrible. But that is just the first way to enter it. Another way is if you were sent a Google Calendar invitation, you can go to the invitation itself. So if you've never accessed Google Calendar, what you want to do is go to those 9 little dots in the top corner, click it, and then select calendar. And this is what it would look like. Here I can tell that this person has not accepted the invitation because the circle is open and not filled. If you have a planned meeting with an advisor or a faculty member, I strongly encourage you to accept the invitation. However, even if you do not, it will still appear on your calendar and all the information about the appointment will as well. So if you click here, it gives you the information about it, tells you the name of the meeting, the date and time, and then also has a link here for Join Hangouts Meet. If you click that, it will bring you directly to that lobby that I showed you a second ago. So now you can access it directly. But showing you again this calendar invitation, it gives you the option to join by phone. It also tells you who is attending, and there is a section for attachments. So here I have attached a PDF as an example. You can also access any attachments from the conference, and I will show you that as well. Again, I'm not going to click join now, but if you did join, this is what it would look like, except that your face would be in the center. It's too confusing to not have myself presenting right now, but just so you know, this is what it would look like. If somebody was presenting their screen to you, that would be filling the center as well. Something else to note, at the top, the URL meet.google.com has a unique code at the end of it. You can use that to enter the meeting. If you go back to that meet.google.com, all you need is this code and you are able to enter it here. If you didn't have anything on your calendar and you needed to enter the code, you would put it right here and it would take you back to that lobby. You can also just directly enter this link. So if you have the code, you can just type meet.google.com and then put the code at the end and it will take you back to that lobby as well. Once you're inside, there's a few things I want to make sure that you are able to do. Here you can see if you click this little picture of people and it has the number 2, it shows you how many people have entered. So it's myself and then also myself, my presentation counts as a person. And this is an area in which you can mute or unmute yourself as well. On chat on the right side, if you have a question for your advisor or your professor that you want to type in but not say out loud, you can type it here, but just so you know, other participants might be able to see that. But it's nice to do that if they're presenting and you don't want to interrupt if your microphone is off. At the bottom, there's some options as well. If you are asked to share your screen or do a presentation, that is where you would select it. This can be helpful in an advising session if you want to show your pause screen. Just be mindful of the other things you have on your computer. On the right-hand side, there are other options. You can change the layout. There's other options for using phone here. And then finally, there's also turn on captions. So if you turn on captions, you are able to have closed captions. So if I made that bottom go away, now you can see everything that I'm saying in a closed caption. I'm going to turn it off for now. In the center, you have the ability to turn off your microphone and turn off your camera. I'm going to do that just for a second so you can see that now my face is my Google icon. Putting my camera back on. And then on this left-hand side is information about the meeting. So it's all that same information that was in the Google Calendar invite. So it has the meeting URL, it has the way to dial in, but also the attachments that were in the Google Calendar are able to be accessed here. So that PDF that I had uploaded, if your advisor has put in some worksheets for you, or if your class is discussing an article and your faculty member has uploaded this to Google Calendar, you can access it directly here. I hope you found this helpful, and if you have any questions, you can email me. My information is at css.tcnj.edu, or of course, you can always contact TCNJ's help desk for any assistance.